Welcome to Robin's Roost. It is Thursday, April 23rd. Happy anniversary to my brother and my sweetest sister-in-law. And it's also almost 11 o'clock at night. Today has been a hard day. Everything was hard today. Nothing came easily. There was a battle with almost every kid in my house today, and it got really wearing, and it ended, well, actually, we're kind of still at battle with one of them. It's ending in a grounding today. It's just been a hard day, and it's also one of those days where you can hear the cars. See them? We have open fields all the way to where you just saw those cars pass behind our house. And some days you can't hear them at all. And then other days they sound like they're driving through our backyard. So sorry about that. I had to come out here and get some fresh air and just breathe and pray. And been doing a bunch of studying in James this week. We're starting a virtual Bible study of James. Next week we're launching. You're welcome to join us. But one of the things that really stuck out to me as I was studying chapter 1 about trials was the purpose of trials and being reminded that God has a purpose in everything that He allows in our lives, and His purpose for trials is for my good and for His glory. He really wants me to become more mature and more Christ-like. It's part of sanctification. And in one of the commentaries I was reading, it was just talking about how God has that purpose and then encouraging us to ask. Have you ever asked God what the purpose of a trial is in your life? I feel like I have sometimes, but then most of the time I just shrug it off as, well, I know this is for my good. But sometimes being dismissive like that actually isn't helpful for me emotionally, or as I process through the pain and the struggle of the trial. And I just felt encouraged that it's okay to ask, God, what is the purpose of this trial? What are you doing? Am I missing something that you want me to see? So I'm going to be doing a little bit of that tonight. And I hope that if you're going through a trial, that you feel that freedom too, that He is our good Father. We can come to Him with anything, and He's not going to scold us, push us away, you know, any of the things that we sometimes do to our human children. He's so patient and loving with us. So anyway, that's heavy on my heart. I have three things that I'm grateful for today, even though today was hard. And my first one that I wrote down was, and you can laugh at me if you want, but I'm thankful for the Peloton app. A while ago, I don't even know how long, but Peloton was created. They have those really fancy spin bikes. Now, I don't have the Peloton bike, but I downloaded the app because right now until April 30th, they're doing a free 90-day trial instead of 30 days free. They have all kinds of classes, cycling, running, strength, cardio, yoga, stretches. You can even take it outside and do like a walk or a run. And I have been so grateful for the app. I think I have done 30. They count each one as a workout. So like if you do a strength class, like biceps, triceps, that counts as a workout. So counting all of the classes total, I think I've done 30 since a week ago Monday. Stir crazy much? but I've been really thankful for it. It's actually really helped me. I've felt already feeling stronger and just more mentally balanced than early on in the quarantine. I'm thankful for the Peloton app. The next thing I wrote down is I am thankful for toilet paper. We bought toilet paper today for the first time since we've all been in quarantine. We haven't been able to find it. And Mark and I were talking today. We've almost felt like It's one of those, like a loaves and fishes situation, or the bottomless jug of oil, where we've actually been, we've had enough toilet paper. Whether or not that's actually a miracle, I'll let you decide. But we were just so thankful. Mark was able to find the last package at the second store that he went to today looking for toilet paper. It's still all out in our area. But now we won't run out again because he found toilet paper. So hooray for toilet paper. I did have a backup plan. I saw a really, she's really cool, but she's really, how do you say? Anyway, she's creative. a friend of mine posted what she was going to do if she ran out of toilet paper. Actually, she might be doing it now because she's that kind of girl. But she cut up old bed sheets, like old flannel sheets, and just into squares. And that's what they're using for toilet paper. They're using them and then putting them in a bucket beside the toilet and then washing them. And she says it's no different than having cloth diapers with babies. So that was my backup plan, but I'm really grateful I don't have to do that. So I guess that's a great thing for today. My last thing that I wrote down was I'm really thankful for prayer, especially on a day like today where I just felt like everything was a struggle. It's such a comfort to go to the Lord, to go to God and ask for help, ask for wisdom, just tell him that I'm frustrated, knowing that he hears me, knowing that he always answers, knowing that he cares. He's a good God. And, you know, before Jesus died, I wouldn't have been able to just go pray. As a woman, I was only would have only been allowed so far into the temple. And even the men could only go so far. The priest, the high priest, could only go into the Holy of Holies once a year. But when Jesus died, that veil separating, keeping people out of the Holy of Holies was torn from the top down. God tore it from the top down. And now we can come, Paul says, boldly before the throne of grace and talk to our Father. So I'm very thankful for prayer today. I hope you're still going. We're down, what is it, like 6 days left? Wow. We're almost there. I know some people are planning on continuing. We were talking just last night about how if you count 3 gifts every day in a year, you'll get almost 1,000. And if you just did 1 or 2 extra, you could get to that 1,000 gifts in a year. And we were thinking about together about that song, Bless the Lord, O My Soul. And how there's the line in that song about, there are 10,000 reasons for my heart to find reasons I can bless the Lord. So I hope you haven't given up. Jump back in at any time, even if it's just one a day. Change your focus from frustration to gratefulness, and it's your outlook determines your outcome. Hope you're having a good night. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye. That makes two. Do 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 do